Good morning from Panhandle Outdoors, America's only daily outdoor TV show. Your source for fishing, hunting, and information for folks who enjoy the great outdoors. Now sit back, relax. It's Panhandle Outdoors.
Okay, so he's getting thicker now?
It's getting thicker now. That's almost like a pea soup. It's got that green, earthy smell.
Yes.
And pretty soon it'll start, the smell will turn sweeter.
How long do you do it?
It'll take about 6 hours, you think?
About 6 hours.
This is a 60-gallon kettle, and we'll usually get about 6 gallons of syrup out of it. So you'll cook out that much moisture or water out of it.
Wow.
We got a brand new one in the shop in there.
She's got a brand new one. We got a while before that. Don't we have to take it down about 2/3?
That's my oldest daughter.
Yeah, Kent State.
That's
known for some kind of demonstration back in the
year. Oh, yeah.
What kind of doctor is she going to be?
Podiatrist.
Where does she wind up in that?
There's only 9 podiatry schools in the country. And she picked the one that she wanted. She got some silkies. And I don't know anything about silkies, so I was trying to research some stuff. And anyway, you just start getting different people's agricultural pages. And Shep has a lot of good articles. So.
George is going to love it. He's not going to run too far.
It's getting less and less skimming now, isn't it?
Less and less skimming. More the impurities cook out. You can see it's dropped a couple of inches since we first started. So,
hi, folks. I'm here. I got a lot of special friends, and this guy right here is very important to me because this is Mr. Mac Eubanks. Now, Mr. Eubanks was my guidance counselor back in high school, but he is a native of West Gaston. Ancestor has been here. Mr. Eubanks, it's so good to see you.
Yes, sir. Yep.
Tell us how far back does your family go here in West Gaston?
Well, for what I know is my dad and family moved to where our home is now back in 1923, mm-hmm. and he was a sharecropper for William Inman. Uh-huh. And Mr. William Inman took a liking to him and made him buy the place, which we thank the Lord he did. And of course, it was a struggle. We doing what we are observing today. We made syrup every year, and of course, that was to live with. And this is a hog-killing weather and not quite cool enough, but yeah, a lot of things went on around Thanksgiving.
And you went to Greensboro High School.
Yes, sir.
And graduated with Mr. Clark.
Yeah, Scott Clark and I started first grade together and graduated together.
What class of Greensboro was that?
1954.
So y'all been friends?
Yeah, we played basketball together and FFA together and those kind of things.
You spent a lifetime in education. I mean, you were my guidance counselor, you were school principal.
41 years.
41 years, yeah. And I've always had a lot of admiration for you.
Thank you. Yes, sir.
You have any memories back in those school days?
Well, I just remember back in those days it was a joy to teach because the young people were very special. Their parents were very special and supportive, and so it was just a family atmosphere when we had school. And those are the memories I have, and I love to follow people like Winston now as a school board member on top of everything else he does, and it makes me feel good that he is working with the schools. So they got to be better when he's part of the administration.
Well, thank you. I know you knew my folks and my brother. We all knew yeah. everybody back in those days.
Yes, sir. Know your mom and daddy real well. And Winston and Wayne were your typical growing up boys, rural boys, and were very athletic and just knew how to get along with people. Just tremendous people.
We were blessed because we had the people we had, the teachers and coaches we had, they were just so special to us. Yeah. I'll always appreciate what you've been in our life and our family's life.
Yes, that's, I can remember, you know, like you played football at Quincy High School and went on to the University of Florida, and I've been very proud of everything, man, that you have done since your days of youth.
Well, thank you. I had some good role models.
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
Appreciate it.
All right, buddy.
All right, this picture here now, Mr. Ebanks. Tell us who's who in this, or where you are, Mr. Clark.
Right here.
Okay.
Where's Scott?
The blue jean overalls in the middle.
Yeah, right there, Scott.
Right there. Okay. Now, y'all barefooted or something?
I am.
You're barefooted in the school picture?
Yeah.
y'all actually went to school barefooted?
Yeah.
Or else I pulled them over when I got there.
Yeah, I did that.
So y'all walked down the hallway, a wood floor, wasn't it?
Yeah. And splinters on them, buddy.
Y'all got splinters at school. Now yeah. That's a story you don't hear much anymore.
That's right. They put diesel fuel on the floors, and they were black. And you get that one of them big old splinters in your foot.
That's funny.
We have 52 things right there.
All right, here we are. Playing basketball.
Yeah.
Fun pictures.
Yeah. Well, that's Wallace Shiver.
Yeah.
I think that's. That's Mac right there.
Right there, that's him, and that's you, Dad.
That's me. Yeah.
Okay,
there you go.
In there.
There you go. Basketball teammates. Did y'all have a good basketball team?
Oh, man, yes.
The senior year, we did pretty well, except Weewall was in the district.
Weewall?
Weewall.
Oh, my goodness.
Year, they were
state champs, huh?
But the Greensboro won it in 51. They won state champs.
State champs in 51. Awesome.
You went on the traveling
yeah,
team.
Yeah, I was on it. In ninth grade, I went got to go to Gainesville.
But me and Wayne Subo didn't get to go because they caught us smoking.
Oh, no!
Our team was so good, though. The subs got to play every last half.
They
had a terrific. His brother, Emmett, he was a dead eye from the
outer circle.
If it had been a three-point line, it would have been. Oh, man, he'd have. No telling what he'd have done. He really was a good shooter.
Yeah, he was.
Y'all played a lot of in the backyard?
Scott had a goal right across the road over there. In the lot, I believe.
We had the back of the old house up there.
Yeah.
We had a barrel hoop for goal.
What kind was it?
You know them hoops that go around the barrel? We'd nail it up there and we'd shoot that side. That's all we had. Even that was regular goal.
You know, the funny thing, though, back in the day, Scott was, he was a big man.
Yeah.
In those days. But then we ran against, we all had a guy about 6'7" or something.
Yeah. Woo!
But Scott could rebound with the best.
Oh, yeah?
I could, but we had one called Harris, was our center.
Yeah.
What was his name?
Edwin Harris.
Edwin Harris. But I could out, he was about 6 inches taller than me, but I could out jump him. I get rebounded. I jump center. I could out jump.
Yeah, we won almost won all of our games, but
they
pressed.
We won all of them at three. We won beat us twice and Carabelle once.
Back in the day.
Yeah.
From top to bottom, tell us where you are.
Like where I'm for school.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, yes. Kingsland, Ohio.
Okay.
You have to say what you're doing, Rebecca.
And what are you doing now?
College of Podiatric Medicine.
Wow. And what kind of work is it? Podiatrist?
What
kind of
podiatrist? Oh, yeah. I'm going to be a podiatrist.
Okay. And you?
I'm sorry. Now I'm at Florida State College of Medicine.
Okay. We talked about this.
Yep.
And I just want to get all four of y'all together.
University of Florida College of Agriculture.
Florida State College of Medicine.
Okay, no. We talked about them earlier, but these are all brothers and sisters. Okay, well, good luck to y'all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And every farm has some fruit trees.
Don't make that face. I don't like that face.
satsumas, grapefruit, kumquats. Tangerines. Ooh, these are good. Okay, Brandy, first thing, it's been cooking down a lot. You can see you had a level when it started.
We've been cooking for 3.5 hours, and this is where we're at after that. We still got a while to go, but you can see how much steam is how much water is evaporated out of the cane juice, and we're getting closer to syrup. We still got a good ways to go. It'll start going quicker now because a lot of the moisture's gone. But we'll have to turn the heat down in just a little while. We're still gonna let it roll like that, and it's still cooking that water out. And you can see how the color's changed.
It's
went from a green color to a more brown color.
They make me feel at home, folks. They brought us all the sandwich out here. Okay. Sweet tea. Okay, so what we got now?
What are you measuring, Dad?
I am measuring the velocity of this syrup. It's got to reach 32, and then it's syrup. And I'm going to put this in there, and it's going to tell me what it's for. 20?
About 18 or 19.
Okay. So what is it now?
18 or 19, and it's got to go to 32.
32.
Before we'll put and call it syrup.
Yeah. Okay. It's cooking on down.
Cooking on down. And we've been at it, four and a half hours?
Four and a half hours.
4 hours and 15 minutes.
All right. Okay, so lost the thermometer. So, Brandon, what are we going to do now?
We're going to try to guess of what we want to cook to. And when it makes a solid sheet is when we're going to pull it off the fire. It's not quite there yet.
It's pretty close.
Okay.
It's almost like making candy.
Needs a little more.
Okay. I agree. We're right at 5 hours.
What does it normally take?
We have about 6 hours.
Then with 3 corn pots.
Well, Scott and I made it by ourselves 1 year.
They've done it more than once by themselves. Like
that had been a job doing it by yourself. Goodness gracious.
We grind the cane one afternoon and got up the next morning and cooked it off.
Wow.
We were younger.
That's kind of when you know it's ready to.
That's what we want. All right, that's a good one.
All right, you tell me. You
want to
pull it?
I don't want
to.
It's already
pulled.
Pull it.
All right, what we're going to do now, we're going to pull it. We're going to strain it through these baby diapers over into this old buffet.
Okay.
And then we've got a spigot over here to bottle on the other side, and that's where Braden's at. And I think his mother, Lori, is going to take over for him.
All right.
And he may go hunting.
I love it.
We usually have a board up there. Right.
Huh?
Just toss me one, any of them.
What did Mama say?
Just toss me one. Want to make sure
right
that
there.
There's one.
Okay, that strains it.
Oh, wow.
All right.
Any
ready for whenever you want.
Trash that was left.
You got to get your hand in the way you
want
to get
both. Is that got to be on your hands? Or?
You get to go whenever you want to go.
I don't have
thin, boys.
Maybe where you are. You don't want it too thick.
Well, we can use two bits. Can I put these on the tree?
Yeah, just watch out. I'm going to put this right here. Just sidestep. Sidestep.
Okay. Perfect. Is that a hog? That's my way. Oh, there's the table. Yeah.
Where do you want to put it? Where are you going to set it down?
Here when it's hot.
Watch out.
That's the joint.
That's right.
That's all right. That's all right. He better go in that bottle.
I don't know. How does she look? I should have been ready to move, though. And what do you think, Braden? Yes, sir.
She doesn't need it.
I don't have the smooth method to break now.
That's all right. That's all right.
Ooh, that's pretty.
Almost looks like a good, good beer. Really dark fun. Beer. No.
That doesn't stop as quick as I thought it would.
You want to change diapers?
I want to change this one. David,
our expenses. So it's time to change diapers now?
Yep.
Is that what we're doing? Okay.
They're not washed diapers, they are clean.
Okay. Clean diapers, okay.
I bought these this year and they are not.
He's got them.
Okay. Here, that's too good. Give him the grant.
Ooh,
different,
honey.
What is
it?
Too tall.
The purpose of that is just keep it clean. We're just filtering, filtering
keep
everything.
Trying to get all any impurities that didn't cook out. We're trying to strain them out.
Right.
It's still real hot.
It's pretty thick.
It's still real hot.
Right now, I just had one that slipped. It's quiet at a certain amount of side. Just telling you. I'm letting you know ahead of time that it's a little bit sticky. It actually is pretty warm. I don't normally have problems.
This sink keeps it warm.
Not my hand.
I know, I saw that.
Who's on this?
No, I agree.
Just someone
standing
over there.
Hey,
listen up.
We don't have any babies here.
And the tree.
Gosh, good shot.
Stick my finger in there.
Right.
Yeah, and
get slapped. Oh, you're going to get a little sample, right? What do you think, Mr. Clark?
That is good and sweet.
Brandon, y'all do a good job on it?
You've done the best we could. It looks pretty, isn't it?
Oh.
What you think?
Let me sample it. Let me see. Mmm, that's real good. That's good.
It's like Lori said.
Oh man, I love cane syrup.
Every year it's the best we've ever made.
It's just a special. Every year it's the best one.
It's the best we've ever made every year.
This has a special taste to it.
Yeah. That is the started off with 60 gallons of cane juice, And that's the cane syrup we have from those 60 gallons. Started with 60 gallons of cane juice, and then we ended up, that's how much syrup we have out of that.
Wow.
It's 3:20 Eastern Standard Time, and we started at 8 o'clock grinding cane, and this is when we're finished.
And it was a family effort.
A family effort, and mom and dad, grandchildren, and cousins, and sons and daughter all helping.
Wow.
Daughter-in-law and son-in-law.
Hey, what an awesome day.
He was trying to put in something so it wasn't hot on your hand.
Well, right, thank you so much. I appreciate it. Okay.
You're gonna block me.
Can you get all of us?
Okay. The Clark family, with the roots in West Gaston County, carrying on a family tradition. It has been a wonderful day, unforgettable day I've had. I want to thank all of y'all. It's just what a great family effort. So thank y'all very much.
Thank you for coming.
Okay, now listen. As we're getting ready to leave this area, one of the things we always do, a tradition on our show, we just have some, look at there. He's so excited about being, look at him, he's so excited. So listen, what do y'all want to tell our viewers?
Good morning,
All right.
Thanks for watching America's only daily outdoor TV show, Panhandle Outdoors with Winston Chester, featuring hunting, fishing, and other activities and information to help you enjoy the great outdoors. Join us next time for Panhandle Outdoors.